They say that kids inevitably grow up to be like their parents, even if they don't mean to. But little by little, Prince Harry is proving that this isn't always true. Prince Charles wasn't the most involved father when his kids were young. Instead, Princess Diana was the one fiercely devoting time to her boys as they grew, exposing them to the reality of the world and making sure they didn't become the spoiled. This all changed when Princess Diana tragically died in a 1997 car crash. Suddenly, Prince Charles was forced to fulfill the role of primary parent, and he did so in a surprising manner. Those few weeks following Princess Diana's death proved he had what it took to be an example to his sons. But despite these positives, it's clear that Prince Harry turned out nothing like Prince Charles. Here's why. Prince Charles largely ignored Princess Diana's turmoil. Numerous comparisons have been made between the plight of Princess Diana and the press and what's happening now with Meghan Markle. One key difference? No one made a move to defend or protect Diana. Least of all Prince Charles. For starters, the 20-year-old bride was absolutely unprepared for the media onslaught she was stepping into on that day in 1981. One minute I was a nobody, the next minute I was Princess of Wales, mother, media toy, member of this family. It was too much for one person to handle, she said in the book Diana, Her True Story. Princess Diana asked for help and got nothing. The Princess of Wales was an emotional person and was prone to dramatic outbursts. However, her pleas to her husband fell on deaf ears. The sound of voices raised in anger and hysterical sobbing could be plainly heard from the suite of rooms occupied by the Prince and Princess of Wales at Sandringham House, royal author Andrew Morton explained in the biography. Diana pleaded, cajoled and quarreled violently with Charles as she tried to win his assistance. The Prince of Wales seemed incapable of understanding or wishing to comprehend the turmoil in Diana's life, he continued. Meanwhile, Prince Harry has been defending Meghan Markle at every turn. This behavior stands in stark contrast to how things are going with Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. Instead of shrinking back and ignoring malicious comments made by the media, the Duke of Sussex is taking a stand against questionable practices. Most recently, he announced an epic lawsuit against the tabloids that would change everything in the royal family. We have continued to put on a brave face. I cannot begin to describe how painful it has been, Harry wrote in a statement explaining why he was suing two British tabloids. My deepest fear is history repeating itself. I've seen what happens when someone I love is commoditized to the point that they are no longer treated or seen as a real person. I lost my mother and now I watch my wife falling victim to the same powerful forces, he continued. Prince Harry will keep fighting the media. Though Princess Diana's death was ruled an accident, most people believe that the paparazzi chasing her had a lot to do with it. It's obvious that Prince Harry is unwilling to make the same mistakes his father did when he ignored Princess Diana's problem with the media. In this way, it's actually a good thing that Prince Harry turned out nothing like Prince Charles. Prince William, 37, is second in the line of succession to the British throne. Aside from being a husband to Kate Middleton, 37, and father to his three children, one of the biggest responsibilities he will ever have in this lifetime is ruling the British monarchy when he assumes the throne. But, before that, the only brother of Prince Harry revealed how he will handle his father's vast Cornwall estate when he inherits it one day. The first son of Prince Charles and Princess Diana divulged that he is likely to follow what the Prince of Wales has been doing for years. Though he is not fond of buildings and designs like his father, Prince William vowed not to do something to disturb the existing situation. I've started to think about how I will inherit the duchy one day, Prince William, reportedly, told farmers in Prince Charles, inside the Duchy of Cornwall. Well, rest assured I'm not going to rock the boat, I'll do much the same as what my father's doing. I'm not so into the architecture, that's the only thing, Kate Middleton's husband went on. For starters, the Duchy of Cornwall has become a multi-million dollar enterprise under the leadership of Prince Charles. As a matter of fact, it is now considered as a business empire that has approximately 130,000 acres of land in Wales and England, and a London property. The duchy, which Prince William will inherit when his father becomes the king, earns an annual income of $27 million, which is used to support the operations of the Prince of Wales office and those of William, Prince Harry, 35, Kate Middleton and Meghan Markle, 38. Meanwhile, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are said to arrive in Pakistan on Monday, October 14. On the same day, Prince William and Kate are scheduled to meet Prime Minister Imran Khan. President Arif Alvi, on the other hand, will meet the royal couple a day after their arrival. Prince William and Kate Middleton have been very vocal about how excited they are to visit the beautiful country of Pakistan. The parents of Prince George, 5, Princess Charlotte, 4, and Prince Louis, 1, are also thrilled to experience the Pakistani culture and meet its people.